Hi, so I'm going to talk a little bit about access policies. So our access policy, so basically we only collect publicly available information, so all our web archives content is open access. We have a legal mandate to collect and provide access to web content interesting to the Portuguese community in the broad scope. So basically this was just one line in one decree law, and legal issues or legal framework was problem was overcome, so quite easy. Then we have an embargo period of 1 year, so we collect the information and we only make it accessible 1 year after, at least. The reason for this is so that, for instance, if someone has a website, we don't want that people can come and see the website that is online on the web archive instead of watching at the original site. So we are a service to help the website owners, not a service to go against them. So we want to preserve their memory. The timer is not working, so give me a sign. So the website owners or the content owners may opt out. However, they must present a proof that they own the rights of the content. Imagine this. Imagine that someone says to remove the site of university. And we must check if this person has the right to ask for that. Okay? So this is very important. Because in the past, in other countries, it happened that governmental sites were removed just because someone said to be removed from the Internet Archive, for instance. Okay, so now, the General Data Protection Regulation. First of all, GPDR stands for data protection, not data privacy, okay? So, it aims to protect the data from being abusively used or to fall into the wrong hands. So, who has read the Article 17? Okay, so this is the famous right to be forgotten. So everybody should read it. It's very simple. It's just a few sentences and it is available in all European languages. And if you are afraid of GPDR, let's think again if you should be afraid. So here it says that, among other things, that the data subject itself have the right to obtain from the controller the right, the erasure of personal data. Personal data, not every data, just personal data. We don't keep personal data about our users, and we only collect published information. So we don't have personal data. This could be the end of it, and you have no problems. But still, it says that paragraphs 1 and 2 shall not apply to the extent that processing is necessary for compliance with legal obligation, which requires processing by a union or member state of a task carried out in a public interest. We are complying with the Portuguese law and you are acting in the public interest. Okay? Still, there's another one that says that the right to be forgotten shall not apply for archiving purposes in a public interest, scientific or historical research purpose. This is the reason why we exist. So once again, it does not apply to us. So the GPDR is something that helps us doing our work and it makes us a lot stronger. Okay, so every information that we have is available online. 1 minute, okay. So people can access it through our user interfaces or through our API, but we're going to talk more about this at 4, so come back at 4, so I won't spend any time here on this. However, we get some complaints. Last year we got 174,000 users and we have an average of 2 removal requests. They're not even issues, they are just people asking. So, but still, some of them will refuse due to after legal analysis. So we have a lawyer and when somebody asks us to remove a content, we send that request to the lawyer that does his proper work. So, we don't have many removal requests, but we have frequent complaints about having such a long embargo period. So people say this is too long, including the website owners. This was quite surprising, but this is very frequent. Because sometimes they ruin their site and they want to get information back from our archive and it is under embargo. Okay, so now a short quiz. Should the author's rights be respected? Is anyone against it? No? Good. So authors have the right to define the accessibility level of their intellectual property. Right? Right? They publish the content openly online. This was their decision about their accessibility level of their intellectual property. Okay? Now, should the original accessibility level should be preserved? Yes, the rule of digital preservation. It was originally open and online. So we do not take ownership of a content that belongs to the authors, because that will be violating their rights, their author rights. And you don't have the right to close access to what was born open. We are people that respect the law. Now, this makes us reach the web archiving paradox. So there's a worldwide open access movement on closed-born scholarly publications. Okay, there's the open access movement, okay? So things that were born closed, we want to open and put them online, such as scientific papers. And on the other hand, we have the closed access movement on open-born web publications. I don't know where these come from, because the Internet Archive was always open, and now somehow there was this movement that appeared, and maybe it's growing stronger, that is closing things that were born open. It's a paradox. Now, libraries are very important organizations in humanity, because they made paid publications accessible to all citizens. People that could not afford to buy books, they were able to access information and learn, and have better expectations in life due to libraries. However, some libraries now make open web publications patently inaccessible to most taxpayers that support them. This is a paradox. So, as final reflection, we have a small initial challenge that is being allowed to provide access to web archive content, but we have a very big challenge that is being able to provide access to web archive content, because it takes a lot of resources. So we should not be afraid of this, of tackling the big challenges and being stuck just in a small one. Thank you.